are at what we call now the Gossman House. This was a home that Bishop Gossman bought about a year after he got here. But he came to us with as a real son of Vatican II. And if you've, his first document to the whole church was the collegial church. You know, let us work together. Let us listen to one another. Sounds like Pope Francis, really. And let us learn together and work together. So he was a great proponent of that.
He was an easy person to work for and with. And if I said I worked for him, he would say, you do not work for me, you work with me. And that's the way we want this to go through your time here.
How long did you all work together?
32 years. I first met Bishop Gossman when he came in 1975.
He became very active in the labor movement. He supported the textile workers up in Roanoke Rapids. And then he supported the farm workers. And then he and Bishop Curlin, the Bishop of Charlotte, together wrote a pastoral letter about the working man.
You know, he could talk with anyone, no matter how rich, how poor. He was just a very down-to-earth person. He had a very dry sense of humor. He had a sense of humor, but few people didn't see some of it. But his sense of humor was very dry. And, you know, he liked to take walks around the lake.
He liked the symphony. Oh, he would read. He'd sit and pray, he'd talk with people.
I don't think a day goes by that I don't remember something that he said or he has done, but he listened. And I think he when he said he would remember them in prayer, he did. I'm sure he did. But I think he was a very compassionate, understanding, loving man.
He was a shepherd. He was with the sheep. I mentioned that Bishop Gossman was simple, didn't like a lot of frills. And one of the things was his crozier. He used this wooden one that friends had made for him. He was going around dedicating schools and churches and meetings galore. It was salvation through meetings. He loved meetings because he wanted to hear you out, and he wanted to hear what other people saying. We're all in this together. And that was his leadership and the way he acted. I think we can learn the dignity of everyone, the simplicity of life, based on a wonderful love of the Eucharist. Bishop Gossman's a great disciple of the Eucharist, and his daily mass was so terribly important. We learn, I think, we learn prayer, but we also learn that we need to live in the present. And this is where we find our salvation.